Hello, welcome to this video on dividing trinomials by binomials. When dividing trinomials by binomials, you will often need to use long division. This process may seem challenging at first, but it will get easier with practice. Let's jump right into an example. X squared plus 4x minus 5, this is our trinomial, divided by x plus 1. And this is our binomial, because it has two terms, and the trinomial has one, two, three terms. We're gonna set up our long division by putting our trinomial underneath the house. So we have our little house right here. This is just what we use to long divide. So we're gonna put the trinomial under here, x squared plus 4x minus 5. And then we're gonna put our binomial on the left over here, x plus 1. So now we want to figure out how many times the first term of our binomial goes into the first term of our trinomial. So x goes into x squared x times because x times x equals x squared. So we're going to write an x right here above our x term in the trinomial. Then we're going to multiply the value we just wrote down, x, by the binomial, x plus 1. So x times x is x squared. And x times 1 is just x. So we have x squared plus x, and we're going to write it right here underneath our trinomial. Now we're going to subtract these two polynomials. So we're going to subtract x squared plus x from x squared plus 4x minus 5. So the x squared terms cancel out, and 4x minus x is 3x. Then we're going to bring down the minus 5. And now we do it again. So from here, we're going to see how many times the first term of our divisor, so our x plus 1, goes into the first term of our new binomial, 3x minus 5. So how many times does x fit into 3x? Well, x fits into 3x three times because x times 3 is 3x. So we're going to add 3 and put that right up here. Now we're going to multiply 3 by x plus 1. So 3 times x plus 1 is 3x. Plus 3, and we're going to subtract the two binomials, so 3x minus 5 minus 3x plus 3. 3x minus 3x is equal to 0, and then negative 5 minus 3 is negative 8. Now we have a remainder here. So when you have a remainder in a division problem like this, you're going to take the remainder and divide it by the divisor and add it to the expression that we have up here. So since we have minus 8, I'm going to put minus 8 in our numerator and then x plus 1 in our denominator. If it was positive down here, we would put a plus sign, but since it's negative, that's why I put a minus sign right here. And then this is our final answer, x plus 3 minus 8 over x plus 1. So when dividing, you will sometimes have remainders like we did here. This is exactly how you would handle them, and it's okay that things don't always divide out perfectly. So that's what you do when it doesn't. Let's try another problem. X squared plus 8x minus 9 over x plus 2. This problem is written in fraction form, but remember, a fraction bar always represents division, so this is just asking us to divide x squared plus 8x minus 9 by x plus 2. So we're going to follow the same steps we did in the last problem, starting by setting up our long division problem. So we're going to have the trinomial underneath here, x squared plus 8x minus 9, and then our binomial will be out here, so x plus 2. Now we're going to figure out how many times x goes into x squared. Well, just like last time, x times x equals x squared, so it goes into x squared x times, and we're going to write that right here. Now we multiply x by x plus 2. When we do that, we get x squared plus 2x, and we write that right here. Now we're going to subtract our expressions. So this will give us 8x minus 2x is 6x, because x squared minus x squared is 0, so these terms cancel out. And then we're going to bring down our minus 9. Now we want to see how many times x goes into 6x. Well, x goes into 6x six times because x times 6 is 6x. So we're going to write plus 6 right here. And again, we're going to multiply 6 by x plus 2 That will give us 6x plus 12. And then we're going to subtract these two expressions. So 6x minus 6x is 0, and negative 9 minus 12 is negative 21. So here we have our remainder again, and remember, when we have a remainder, we just take this number, and that will be the numerator of our fraction, so we'll have minus 21 over, the denominator will be the divisor over here, so over x plus 2. So our answer for this problem is x plus 6 minus 21 over x plus 2. Before we go, I want to try one last example. 2x squared plus 4x minus 12 divided by x minus 6. So again, we're going to set up our long division problem just like we have been. So we'll have 2x squared plus 4x minus 12 divided by x minus 6. Then we're going to see how many times x goes into 2x squared. X goes into 2x squared 2x times, because x times 2x is 2x squared. So now we're going to multiply 2x by x minus 6, and we'll get 2x squared minus 12x. Then we are going to subtract our expressions. This will give us 4x minus negative 12x, that turns into 4x plus 12x, which is 16x, and then bring down the minus 12. Then we see how many times x goes into 16x. It goes in 16 times, because x times 16 is 16x, so we write plus 16 right here. And then we multiply 16 by our expression x minus 6. So that gives us 16x minus 96. And then from here, we're just going to subtract our expressions. Our 16x's will cancel each other out, and we'll have negative 12 minus negative 96. So it's like negative 12 plus 96, which gives us 84. And again, we're going to do what we've been doing the last few times and add our remainder. So we'll add 84 over x minus 6. So our answer for this question is 2x plus 16 plus 84 over x minus 6. Now, just as a disclaimer, for all of these examples, we've had a remainder. But sometimes things will divide out nice and evenly and not have any remainder. So if you get a 0 right here at this last step, you're not going to have a remainder, and you don't have to worry about this fractional part. But if you do have a remainder, it's nothing to be concerned about. It's just a simple, easy, extra step that you now know how to do and are hopefully comfortable with. So I hope that this video on dividing trinomials by binomials was helpful. Thanks for watching, and happy studying!